Hello everybody and welcome to Subnautica Below Zero. The wait is over! We can finally get into this. If you're new to the channel, welcome. This original Subnautica brought a lot of people to the channel. And a lot of people have been, you know, for the, you know, the years since that finished. People have always, who have watched it throughout the time of it being finished. And people binge watching it all the way through and saying, are you going to play Below Zero? I always said yes. And the day is here, the 14th of May, we're finally going to be playing Subnautica Below Zero. So I don't think... Wow. Okay, so there, that puts it into perspective. The 5th of February 2019, that is right around with the very first Early Access 8 build, it looks like. I played this game and I did a video on the channel. It might not be on the channel anymore, I may have got rid of it, but I basically did play the Below Zero in its earliest form when there was basically nothing in the game. That was literally it. So I know nothing about this. It's a completely blind playthrough, pretty much, apart from what I saw, but I could barely remember what I even saw in the Early Access build. It was like the first release of Below Zero, so there was virtually nothing. There was only like one biome, and that was like the starting one. So I'm so excited to get into this. Let's just get rid of that. We don't need that. And I can't wait to... I'll jump into this. Right, let's do it. Survival, freedom, like survival but without hunger or thirst, hardcore, one life, no thanks. Let's go with survival. Survive alone on 4546B, which is the planet, while investigating the death of your sister. Oh, here we go.
This is the farthest that I could take you on company space bucks, Robin. You sure you want this? The research is in everything.
It is to me. And Sam. I need to know what happened.
The meteor storm.
I can use it for cover from Altera's eyes.
Gonna miss you, Robin. Eyes.
I'll find my way back.
Holy shit! What? Oh my god, this music! Oh my god, what an intro! That was so quick and fast-paced, but I love it!
Approaching 4546 speed. Surface temperatures. Drop pod deployed.
Oh my god. There's a meteor shower going on right now. Come on. Are we in? We're in, just like that. Holy shit, what is going on? What the shit? Nutrient block. Oh my god, I remember Nutrient Block so well! What the hell is going on? Run!
Holy smokes! That did not go as planned. I should find a way into the water and get to the drop pod.
Whoa. Got some stutters. That's fine though. It's just loading, you know, everything in. Okay, apparently these plants make your PC freeze up. My god, that's like so perplexing though to look at. Perplexing? Is that the right word? Oh my lord. I think this is the beginning area of the game. As in like the one that I played in the early access. Well, here we go, ladies and gents. Our first dive into Below Zero, quite literally. Oh, it's just as beautiful as I remember it. All right, let's get to work. Bit of titanium, some quartz. Oh, it's good to be back, baby. Break Galena outcrop? Oh, I forgot. I have oxygen. I can't breathe fully. I like the HUD. The HUD looks a bit sharper than it did. Survival. Okay, right. We have to read these in a bit because there's a lot to take in right now. We are like... We need to get to our pod thing that dropped. Dude, oh, the fish. Hoop fish! Ah! It's... What's that noise? Just... Oh, no. I'm already getting my fear of the ocean is coming back all of a sudden. I just remember
Oxygen.
This... Oops. I just remember this is... This ain't... Oh, my God. It's like a snowstorm or something, or a blizzard. I swear I could hear something growling. Dude, honestly. Peeper! Come back! What the hell was that growl? Let's just get inside.
Found the drop pod.
Okay, right. Drop pod. Logs and communications.
I want to offer my sincerest condolences on the passing of your sister. I got to know Sam better towards the end of my mandate with Altera on 4546B, when we were thrown together as base mates at Outpost Zero.
Outpost Zero?
She spoke often and fondly of you. I thought you should know, it didn't sit right with me when Altera blamed Sam's death on negligence.
No.
The Samantha Ayu I met was many things. Kind, clever, devoted to her work, but never negligent.
Okay.
I wish I could offer you something more substantial, but my access to information has been cut off. You may be in a better position to look into things than I am. If you're able to, Delta Station was our HQ. They were in a big hurry to leave, and there might still be information to be found there. It has a big radio tower, impossible to miss. I hope you find the answers you seek.
Delta Station. Lillian Bench, okay. Right, so we need to go to Delta Station at some point or find it. Big hurry to leave, then there might still be information to be found out there. There's a big radio tower, impossible to miss. Okay, so what I remember is that Altera is a very, like, and generally society has become very contract-based. Everyone cares about what contract they are and whatnot. Notice of death. Dear Miss Io? I don't know how to pronounce that. Io? I'm assuming it's Io. On behalf of Zeta Landon, 4546B Robotics Section Leader, and Indra Cormac, President of Altera Transgov, I regret to inform you the death of Samantha Io. She died on planet 4546B, regrettably as the result of injuries sustained in an accident arising from her own negligence. Right. Please allow me to communicate the most profound condolences for the loss of your sister. While further details are unavailable at this time, you will receive contact from the Department of Insurance and Recuperation concerning your responsibilities as next of kin with regards to repayment of damages and legal fees. Yeah, see, they're very stingy and kind of grimy as a company. If you have any questions, you may file form blah blah blah, and your query will be addressed in sequential order. Yikes. So, Sam was our sister, and we are Robin? I want to say Robin? Yeah, Robin.
Robin, guess what? I got the job. I'm going to 4546B. Now I'll be able to improve the mechanical avian amphibian under real-world stress conditions. Listen, I know your stance on Altera, but I just hope you're happy your sis is happy. I sure hope my sis is happy. I can't wait till we talk again. Oh, I wanted to ask you something. Can you watch my Augie while I'm away?
Augie?
I need someone I can trust to look after my best little potato. Potato, listen. I tried, but that name is just not sticking. He's my little Oxtrobite. I'll leave Oxtrobite. The starchy tuber's nicknames to you. Anyway, if you say yes, thanks, baby sis. Love you.
Wow. So, it's a lot more story-based. You can already tell that.
Well, Sam, I guess I might as well gather some tools and resources before starting my search. Hope that radio tower's as easy to spot as Will said.
Is that? Yep, it's raining. I thought I was hearing something. I was just like, what the hell is that noise? Dude, the audio design in this is so good so far already. Right, wait. Catch bladderfish. Oh. I guess we should listen to all of these before we start doing things.
4546B to Robin. Come in, Robin. Remember when we used to play old-timey Space Explorer? This is kind of like that, but it's even harder to communicate. Well, let's
see.
This
is sweet.
I got your last message. Altera is not, as you put it, Alterrorizing me. Things are going well. My project has a new name. Say goodbye to the mechanical avian amphibian, and hello to spy penguins.
Spy penguins?
They're training the bots to mimic the creatures. Check out the photo. And I think I'm kind of seeing someone.
Oh.
I know it's not like me to just find a date, let alone on a mostly uninhabited
planet. I was
going
to say, it's a strange place to find love, but you know.
Actually, you know what? Forget I said anything. Yeah, it's probably not even a real thing, but anyway, I'm sorry to hear Xenoworks might be strapped in the revenue department. Sounds like they still have you busy Xenoworking, though. I know there's no way to guarantee an alien intelligence startup will succeed, but you've put so much into it. I hope they find a way to keep going. I know how much it means to you, getting to work at a small place where you have control over your research. All right, I gotta go. Later, baby sis. Love
so
you.
She's our older sister. Okay.
Hey, Robin. I got your Augie photo. Thanks so much for taking care of him, even though he's a cranky Hey! The nickname actually fits that way. Cranky potato. I know he can be a handful, but I really appreciate it. I'm a bit worried about my other baby, the mission. One of my penguins found something. Something big. But Altera is just like, nothing to see here.
Oh.
Honestly.
Oh, that's spooky.
I can't answer, so you can't, you know, rub it in my face. Go ahead. Bask in the fact that you were a little bit right about them. My project is on the line. My job. My safety. I heard about Xenoworks getting bought.
So
I'm sorry. But at least you still have your job. Guess you're one of us now. Like it or not, welcome to the Altera family.
Okay, so Altera bought Xenoworks, and we worked for Xenoworks, so they took
Love
us
you.
On.
Keep your chin up. Eye on the alien prize. Hey, Robin. I'm sorry my last message was so awful. I've been under a lot of stress.
Oh, you
I'm
can
not
see
sure
she's slowly becoming
anything.
More sad.
I can't
by
really
each message.
Talk about it either. Oh, and I'm definitely not dating anyone on this water planet. Don't know what I was thinking there. Have I told you how cold it is here? Get
what?
This. I can't even get my wash and go dry before the wind freezes the moisturizer in my hair. Wild, right? Well, anyway, I'm sure you're mad at me after what I said, but I could really use a friend.
After what I said?
You're my sister. I love you. I'm sorry.
So she's getting progressively sadder, and... Uh-oh. This...
Hey, Robin? I really need someone to know. I'm afraid something terrible is gonna happen. You were completely right about Altera, okay? You were right. I was wrong.
Oh, so she gave him too much of the benefit
of
the doubt.
Potato. I admit it. Sorry. Bad attempt at a joke. I don't know what to do. I guess I should just come out and say it at this point. I've said this much already. We found a frozen leviathan that's infected with Kara.
Oh,
Altera
no.
thinks they can use it for something. Weapons, experimental treatments, a whole range of things. But one end of the range is ugly, dangerous, but profitable, of course. What if it gets out while we're messing around with it? Or worse, what if it ends up a bioweapon in the wrong hands?
Yeah, there's a lot of things that could go wrong with that.
I'm overreacting, but I don't think I am. Anyway, message me back, please. I could really use a friend. You're my sister. I love you.
And then she died soon after that, I'd imagine. Wow, okay, that got, like, kind of, like, adorable at the beginning and, like, you know, quite cute. And then it got really sad and kind of depressing really quick. Right. Oh, that's so good to hear that sound. Copper wire, wiring kit, battery, fiber mesh glass, silicone rubber. All the classic stuff, really. So we got titanium, we need fiber mesh. We definitely want a scanner at some point. I think we, from what I remember, we need the mushrooms to make. Got it. So I have to remember everything again all of a sudden. We need ribbon plant. I don't know. And we need creep vine samples. God, we're really starting from nothing here. So what do we need to make silicone? Creep vine seed cluster. Well, we can just go and pick that up, right? Oh, it's dark outside. No. Dude, come on. You know how me and the dark and the ocean don't go together. Those... That's an unholy trinity, that is.
Bladderfish. New creature discovered.
New creature discovered. I like the voice of the robot. Let's get what we can. Oh, it's so good to be back playing a fresh experience in the world of Subnautica, honestly. It's so good. Oh, we got some quartz over there. I am so...
Early intake recommended.
Yes, I know. I am so slow. 9 seconds. Uh-oh. We're fine. We're fine. No problems here. Right, so, as we discover new things... There is something making a noise out there, and I can hear it. It's like... I can hear it. Sustenance. Cooked food. So we can make glass. We picked up quartz. We need to find a creep vine seed cluster. Air bladder. Emergency flotation device. Chemical reaction produces lighter than air gas for fast put. Oh, so that's if we need to get to the surface really quickly. If that's a new item, I'm not sure, but I never use that in regular Subnautica. Right, we need a battery, so let's make a battery. We need ribbon plants. I don't know what ribbon plants are. We need to try and find this stuff as fast as we can, really. Ribbon plants. I don't even know where to start, to be honest. Bullseye shroom. Okay, there are noises coming from this ocean that I really don't appreciate. I really don't like them. God, my oxygen sucks as well. And my speed is awful. This is what I love about Subnautica. Building your way up, though. Fine. I'm hearing something.
Oxygen.
And it's putting me on edge. There is something making noise. We need oxygen. God, I'm really kind of... Mix some more water. Right, we need sustenance as well. So we need to get some food. Grab some peepers. Peeper, come here. Don't go swim away from me. An
new
Arctic peeper.
Discovered.
So they're not like the regular peepers, they're Arctic peepers. I like how there's going to be like a little spin on most of the creatures as well. Cold and spongy. Ew. Why is spongy such a disgusting I accidentally did something. I pinned it. Oh, you can pin recipes now?
Mm. Vital signs stabilizing.
Actually, let's drink our water too. We like to be on top of things here. Right, it's getting daytime. We need to find this ribbon plant. So we'll... Ooh, come on. Peeper, peeper, peeper. No, it's too fast. I can't catch it. Oh my god, there's something making noise. I'm not sure if it's just a background effect or whether there is, because usually in Subnautica there is a creature nearby making those noises.
Supply cache nearby.
Supply cache? Again, ribbon. Ribbon.
Ribbon plants contain electrolytic materials that can be used in energy storage.
Okay, right, so ribbon is around here. Ribbon plants are around here. Good to know. Let's grab another bladder fish. We'll try and get some more. Okay, so they're in like their own... That's got to be a creature, right? Making that noise. There's no way that's just an ambient sound effect. In Subnautica, it's always a creature. There's never just background roaring going on for the sake of it. There's always something making that noise. And it's freaking me out because That means it's probably somewhere close by. Oh, dude, these peepers are really not, like,
oxygen.
Wanting to be my food today. I really want to eat them, but they won't let me. I don't know why. It's an odd thing. Right. Make some more water. We'll have a bit of backup, because we like to be prepared here. Tell you what, we had some sticky situations back in the original Subnautica, and we managed to fight our way out every time. Right, battery done. What was I even making a battery for? Scanner. Although, it's probably not the best thing to be making a scanner right now. What I want is we don't even need a knife, actually, at this point, as of yet. What we need is fins. So we need silicone rubber for that. So we need to find creepvine seed clusters. And we don't have any creepvines near us, so we need to go and find some of those. There's an emergency supply cache over there. Actually, it's going to be an oxygen tank. I'm so, like, scatterbrained right now because... Dude. If there is, like, a leviathan making that noise, and it is, like, a ginormous leviathan, and it's so big that I can hear it all the way over here, and it's actually in its own biome, that's not making me comfortable. We need fiber mesh. Okay, what does it take? Creep vine. So we need to find creep vines, is the bottom line here. So we might as well make a scanner at this point.
All right, I have a scanner.
That little green bar next to it, I'm assuming that's the battery? Here we go. Pink narrowleaf. This grass-like species grows in small clusters near coral bridges. Twisted mandrake. The twisted mandrake grows in temperate coral zones. Its leafy canopy photosynthesizes sunlight. That noise. While providing shade to bulbous structure underneath. That's so cool. Oh my god, it's so good to be back scanning things. Discovering new life at every turn. Just seeing whether it's friend or foe. Ooh, come on, peeper. Oh, there's creep vines here. We need to be faster because... What is that? Oh, what the hell is that? Oh, that freaked me out. Sea monkey? Friend or foe? Foe! Foe! I think it's a foe! Oh, what is it doing? It's coming after me! Oh, I need oxygen as well. It's making weird noises! Oh, get away from me, you freaky little thing! Okay, I'm getting chased by things called sea monkeys. This isn't good. Not a good start. He's not following me, is he? Right, we got seed clusters here. Let's just get them and go, because kelp forests are never the best thing in Subnautica. We'll just pick up loads of them.
New blueprint synthesized.
We'll just pick them up and leg it. We'll just get out. Whoa, it's gotten so much more like a more pale blue in the
oxygen.
Ocean color. God. This game's already, like, freaking me out. With little... Dude, a tiny little thing called a sea monkey is weirding me out. Wait until, like, meet new leviathans and crap like that. We can scan a bladderfish. What does it say? I mean, we know what a bladderfish is. We read these in the last of Nausicaa, so... We can always reread them, though. Right. Fiber mesh. No, silicone rubber is what I need. Fins! There we go. Do we need to equip them? Oh, it auto-equips them. So 15% faster, so hopefully we'll be able to actually catch some fish now. And we also need a knife so we can make some more silicone rubber. And we can make ourselves a knife too. Perfect. Right, we're looking really good. So we can go and make some fiber mesh now. We can just go and get those creepvine samples. And then we can make an oxygen tank. And then we'll need a compass as well. Right. Nope, that's storage. Oh. That was weird. Right, let's Let's put these in here for now, save some space. Hopefully we'll be able to catch some peepers now and be able to get our food up. That's a bit better, a little bit faster. No. Scan it. Scanning's more important than actually getting my food. Okay, right, so we've got... Dude, what the hell? This thing, whatever this thing is that's roaring is... Honestly,
oxygen.
I keep... I'm having, like, PTSD flashbacks to the Reapers. It's, like, making me freak out. Because it makes me think there's something right there next to me about to kill me. It's like my primal senses are just, like, kicking in when that happens. Cool. We'll save the nutrient block because those are really useful. Let's make some more... let's make another battery. Just because we can. We might as well. So we need to go and get some more of the kelp forest stuff. So the kelp forest was over here, wasn't it? The creep vine forest. It's raining again. So there's a lot of environmental stuff going up on the surface, which I really like, because Subnautica, it was never changing. So I'm assuming stuff on the surface will be a bit more interesting, because obviously, judging by the beginning, we can go on land as well, properly, you know?
New blueprint synthesized. Oxygen.
Yes, I know, oxygen. Go, go, go. Go. Oh, whoa! Did you see that? The peeper just did like a little hop out the water. Did they all... I mean, that's always what they did, right? That's in their description, that they come out the water and hop like that to escape their prey or something like that. Oh yeah, actually, we've got a scanner, so we could scan for the sea glide now, right? Yeah, there we go. So we need three of those. We did see one earlier. Dude, genuinely, that growling sounds like it is right next to me. And I don't much appreciate it. Right, here we go. Fiber mesh. And oxygen tank.
Adding additional blueprints to your data bank.
So pipes, floating air pump.
The standard oxygen tank can be upgraded for deluxe and VIP breathing.
Upgraded for deluxe and VIP breathing. So we'll make a first aid kit because God knows what we're going to get attacked by. At this point, I don't even know what to expect. Crystalline sulfur is already an item that's like we need to make stuff. Computer chip. God, memory's flooding back right now. First aid kit, floater. So we could get a compass at some point, but we need silver. So I don't know in below zero where to get silver exactly. We need to try and find some more sea glide fragments because obviously that is key to us actually moving around quite briskly. So I think we should just go to the emergency supply cache at this point. Oh, wait, hang on. We've got a temperature thing down in the bottom left. Wait, can we die of freezing? Uh-oh. It's coming from that direction. It's freaking me out. I'm scared to go in that direction. Come on. So close. Copper ore. We'll collect what we can along the way. We got so much more. Oh, lead. Yes, there we go. Oh, it's one of those sea monkeys. They're freaky. Those things are weird, dude. I don't like them. They're going to be my mortal enemy. Oh, whoa. Look at this. Dude, this is so cool. What the hell?
Oxygen.
Brine wing? Oh god, it's attacking me, I think. We'll read about those in a second, because I can't really sit still here. Please say there's a breeze. I could breathe on the other side of this. Oh my god, are they freezing things? Salt deposit. Grav trap fragment. Uh-oh. Please, don't touch me! Don't touch me! Ah, I don't like it! A flare. First aid kit. Oh, we could take the beacon. Oh, that goes
show
deep.
Or hide the signals of your choice with your Xenoworks PDA. Now with surface support.
Holy. Oh, wow, there's loads of crates around here, actually. I think I just saw a sea glide fragment off the side as well. Disinfected water. Another nutrient block. Ooh! Oh, God! Oh, God, sea monkey. Have I scanned you? I did scan you, didn't I? Stay away from me, you little freak. How can I do anything while this little shit's following me? Right, there you go, 2 out of 3.
Warning, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Yeah, I know, I know. Oh my god, the vibrant colors in this and the way the lights like show through the water and stuff is so cool. Shelf coral. We'll have a good read of this in a second. Scan everything. Again, now that I'm around here, I can start hearing whatever that thing is that's making noise out there. So we can actually craft a beacon already. Right, let's cook our peeper. Copper wire. So I would like a compass because that will give us some orientation as to what, where we are and what we're doing. But we need a wiring kit, and for that we need silver, I think. Yeah, we need 2 silver ore for that. So, wiring kit, scanner, repair tool. But we need crystalline sulfur, so it's not even thinking about trying to get that. Let's have a look. Let's eat that. We've actually got quite a good amount of stuff here already. Let's switch, put the flare in there, because I never used flares before. So, I'm going to start using that pinning system, I think, as well. Because that seems really useful. Right, here we go. Bladderfish, a fast prey fish camouflaged against the ice. Like the common peeper, it is fast and relatively intelligent, allowing it to survive in large numbers. Researcher notes, don't like the auto-generated name, suggest Icelops. Assessment edible. Herbivores large. Okay, so it's a herbivore. It's not going to kill me. A medium-sized and intelligent herbivore which shows great interest in other life forms and their possessions. More research is needed to understand this life form and its behavior. 2 finger-like appendages on each forearm are tipped with suction pads for basic object manipulation. Its large turquoise crest is made of rigid bone, is possibly used as a ram, although this has not been observed. Sea monkeys roam the ocean almost playfully, largely fearless of predators. Seen to form small nests where they hoard objects for of interest for unknown purposes. Could we find where they hoard the items then and take them? So it's a really low threat level and it's not going to kill me. It just looks like it has an interest in what I've got. So brine wing. Right, these are carnivores. This was trying to kill me. A medium-sized predator known to spit super-cooled salt water to freeze its prey from afar. A large bladder on the brine wing's underside fills with seawater as it swims. Some water is filtered out through an internal membrane, leaving behind a strong saline solution. 2 flat, transparent, extendable fins act as radiators, releasing heat and cooling the bladder's contents. The brine wing can then contract its bladder, expelling the supercooled brine and freezing the seawater up to several meters away from it. While warm-blooded life forms may suffer minor injuries on contact with the brine, it is not cold enough to freeze most vertebrates. The real danger is being helplessly encased in a block of ice, sinking ever closer towards the brine wing's jaws. So they can freeze you. Okay, so they can freeze you and then they'll just attack you. We'll read some of this other stuff as well, soon-ish. So we need to go out and... Oh god, it's... dark. Oh my gosh, look at this. Gorgeous as ever, Subnautica, gorgeous as ever. Right, so we need to find some sea glide. We need to find one more sea glide fragment, actually. We've got everything else. And then once you've got a sea glide, we can really start to explore and have a look at some different areas and travel out a bit more. Our oxygen... Oh my god! That is a hell of a blizzard out there. Whoa, what? Oh my god, I remember these guys. Oh, it's so dark. Titan holefish. So what I... Yeah, you can... Oi, off you. Yeah, I think he's trying to take my things out my inventory. Get out. Get away. You're not having my things. That might have been a bit cruel. I felt really bad after doing that, actually. Okay. So, we need, like, silver to get a compass. And I can't find any sea glide fragments. What are these saying? It says something underneath the chance of copper. Budding? Right, oh, cool. Let's go and make a sea glide. Actually, what does it require? We need lubricant. What do we need for lubricant? I think we need the creepvine seed clusters to make lubricant, from what I remember. So, we'll go and do that. We'll go and make the sea glide and then we'll have a look around, I guess, and see what else we can find. But I am not entirely looking forward to it because this consistent noise in the background of this thing roaring is putting me on edge ever more. And not in a good way. Is there a good way of being put on edge? The fun way, I guess? I don't know. Where is it? There. Sea glide.
The sea glide is a personal transportation device used for high-speed free diving. Contains a built-in light and map.
Yep, I remember well. Okay, right, let's move that there. And we'll put 4 as our med kit, I guess. And so 1's our knife, 2's our scanner. I think I seem to remember having scanner as my 2 and my knife as 1 all the time. Whoa, we got like a map here. Oh, look at that. We're so speedy now. So lights. So we can toggle. So this is the... We've actually got... It's a lot better than it used to be, actually. The map didn't really... Wasn't very useful. Do I play devil's advocate and I go towards the noise that's being made? I want some of these more unique... Whatever you call them. That noise is getting louder. It's getting a lot more, I would say mountainous, but it's getting a lot more rocky. It's making me more, oh god, I hate.
Oxygen.
This is the feeling I hate in Subnautica, is moving into a new area and not knowing what hides inside of it. The hell is that noise?
That sounds like a distress call.
A distress
transmission
call.
Transmission of unknown origin. Source of transmission depth calculated at approximately 200 meters.
That was a freaky noise. Oh, there's something... Table, Carl.
Warning. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Oh my god, what is that? Okay, time to go. I felt like I shouldn't have been down there, to be honest. Okay. That thing looked awful.
Warning. 30 seconds of oxygen
remaining. So you only get lead from those. Okay, so we have some weird double-sided fin, like, shark thing. I don't know what it was. But dear God, it looked awful. I don't really want to go close to... Oh, this does not look fun. I hear noises. Oh dear God. Yeah, it looks like they're down in there, down in the depths.
Warning. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Yeah, that area doesn't look like a very fun area. That doesn't look like a good place to be.
Picked up what sounds like a distress call. Who or what is out here calling for help?
Yeah, seriously.
Didn't sound human. Maybe it's from a remnant of Architect technology. In her message, Sam's colleague did say there was something important here. Even if it's just a mimic from one of the more intelligent aquatic specimens, that could be a major find. Or if it's from Altera, it could have bearing on what happened to Sam. I should definitely check it out.
Yeah. Oh, we actually got other personal logs.
I was a little nervous about dropping into an unknown area, but luckily, this biome seems to have an abundance of minerals I can use for tools and upgrades. I didn't want another situation like Byzantos 5. When Xenoworks dropped me off, there were barely any resources. I survived off the land for 3 months with just a knife, my lucky PDA, and some rope.
Wow.
I am still kind of proud of that, though. In goes a battery and titanium, out comes a scanner. Every xenobiologist's favorite tool. This planet has some fascinating flora and fauna.
It does indeed.
I can't wait to learn about them.
Also some terrifying.
This will also give me access to a greater tool set. I'm assuming Altera left behind tech that I can scan for blueprints. That should make surviving and exploring out here a bit easier. Don't worry, Sam. I haven't forgotten I'm here for you. But it can't hurt to do a little research on the side, right? I know you would have done the same. I will find out what happened to you. I promise.
Okay, cool. Oh, I have a lot of titanium. We can put some of that to the side for now. I don't need quite that much. And it's always good to have a beacon on you, I guess. We'll put the nutrient blocks away as well, because I don't want to, like, accidentally. And we'll put the health kit away. We'll just kind of keep some backup stuff. So there is somewhere I do want to continue to go, because there was some stuff we could scan. I can't quite remember what direction it was exactly. I believe it was this way, but I could be wrong. Yeah, here we go. So, we had some stuff to scan over in this area. Oh, what is that? Creature egg. Probably not a good idea to be stealing random eggs, but... Oh my god.
30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
That does not... Okay, get away, sea monkey. That does not look like a healthy place to be. So, we're gonna actually go down here. We'll put a beacon here. Okay, so what do we want to call it? Okay, that's not right. Stalk. Pit. We'll call it a stalk pit for now. Cool, we got the grav trap. Oh, is that... Argentite. Silver! There we go. I kind of tempted to go down in there. I want to see where... So there is silver around here. Cool, so we can actually make a compass now as well. There are a lot of crates around here that we didn't initially see. Frost anemone. And aside it grows on the underside of ice floes and icebergs. The anemone's trendles are covered in thin, stinging hairs that paralyze small fish and plankton that are broken down for nutrients. Should be trimmed to effectively harvest the heart. Carefully harvest for high nutritional value. So we can cook that. And what are these? These look like...
Oxygen.
Oh, don't touch them. Is the moral of the story. Dude, that's such a cool little, like, pit area. So... Ah! Okay, that scared me a little bit. I'm frozen. How did... Oh, we left click. You little turd. He didn't do any damage to me, though. So we can actually eat those anemone hearts as is. Oh? Mineral detector. Databank. Mineral detector. We can find...
synthesized.
We can find minerals? With that? That's so cool. I mean, you'd think so. With a mineral detector, you'd think you'd be able... Okay, let's not go that way, because we can't go up for air. What is the... Another creature egg. Dude, it looks so cold up here. I wonder what the temperature is in the water. Penguin! The penguins are here. Oh, dude. Oh, it's another one of these. I'm a bit nervous. What's in here? No, oh! Oh, you've got to be joking, not you again! I can't believe the game got me with that again. That was almost like a perfect repeat of the original.
Warning, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Dude, this is the sort of place you don't want to get stuck in. Ever. Right, let's head back to base. We've unlocked some things. We can craft some new stuff, so we'll head back. Okay, right, let's have a look. So we can actually make a wiring kit. And... copper wire. Compass. So we need proximity detector used to locate minerals, fragments, and other items with identifiable signatures. So that's definitely a must. We need to get one of those. So we need more ribbon plants to make a battery, and then after... So let's pin it. Cool, right. So we need one more bit of copper. Please give me copper. Thank you. And ribbon plants. But we need to find ribbon plants, and I don't quite know how to suss them out just yet, rather than just randomly coming across the little... Here we go. So they are quite easy to find. They glow and all that, so. Violet bow. I am scanning another different plant. God, there's so many different plants here. Right, there you go. That's our ribbon plant done. We need to find some more of the mobile vehicle bay as well, fragments, so we can craft a vehicle. I wonder if we've got the classics. I can't even remember what it's called. The little thing. Okay, the weather's kicking up again. Right, mineral detector.
The mineral detector can sniff out raw materials, potentially saving you hundreds of hours of searching.
Oh, whoa! That is such a cool tool. Calvarite? Wow, okay, that's gonna come in handy. That saves you so much time just randomly searching. Right, so what do- oh, we should have unpinned that actually, right? So you do need to unpin things. Unpin, and we need more batteries. So we'll go and hunt some raw materials to make some batteries. Whoa! It's like Northern Lights. That is so cool. We need to get back up on land at some point and have a look around as well up there. Okay, right. So we can make a couple batteries now. Right, let's unpin that. So, there's not really anything else for us to build apart from the repair tool, but we don't know where any crystalline sulfur is immediately to us. So, we need to just look around, pretty much, as of right now. Maybe get some food, actually, before we go. And once we're all fully, you know, we've got a lot of food and... Again, let's... We're picking up a lot of, like, really neat stuff here, so... So you can't actually cook these weird things I picked up, the anemone hearts. You can just eat them, and that's about it. And we've got a creature egg in here as well. So we'll put that away, we'll put a bunch of our titanium away, and a few bits of our lead, and a few bits of our quartz. And I'm actually gonna, so I took out the old battery, I'm actually gonna save that, because no doubt at some point we're gonna get a battery charger. So we need to kind of just travel out a bit, and that's what I'm gonna do. As much to my dismay as I don't want to, I'm gonna travel out a bit and see what we can find. Actually, before that, let's do the smart thing and get some food for the trip. Time to head out. So it looks like west, like north is to this mountain, whatever that is. And south is out into the ocean, by the looks of it. If it does... I think it opens up. It's like a channel in sort of thing, and it opens up a lot more. I can actually see, like, a little island or something over there. Yeah, here we go. This is where the not-so-nice territory is. Where those weird shark things and... I heard the roar. Dude, it looks so cool, though. The design on this is insane. Oh, there's actually ribbon plants over here as well. What the frick was that? That looked big, whatever that was. It spawned in and then went disappeared all of a sudden. I didn't really get a good look at it. Oh my god, it's like a horror film all of a sudden. Oh, that's a fragment of something. Oh my... What the... That thing is quick. Sea truck? Excuse me? A truck? That thing is quick. I do not want to be on the receiving end of whatever that damage that thing does. That was scary. That thing is actually scary how quick it is. That thing has put me so on edge right now, how quick that is. If I accidentally run into one, I feel like I do not have the speed to outrun that. Oh, it's one of those shark things. My god, they're quick as well. Oh, there's so many new creatures around me. I don't like it. I just want to scan this. We need one more. I'm trying to keep vigilant so I don't end up going into something I don't want to. Oh, there's another fragment of something down there. Oh, no, 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 no. Okay, okay. I'm sorry, I'll leave. Bye.
Warning. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
He did like a swivel. He did a swift turn into me then. Oh my god. I didn't even get to see what that thing looked like properly. The really quick one. Who did the really quick paddle. It's like that fragment is being protected by that thing. Where is it? It's over there now. I want to try and get a scan off here.
Warning. Passing 100 meters. Oxygen efficiency decreased.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Go, 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 go. Okay, we didn't anger it. Oh, I don't like this. Oh, this is getting more open as well. Oh, I hate it. Oh, it gives me... it gives me goosebumps seeing really big ocean... open ocean. It's so cool. I find the ocean fascinating in real life, you know, on Earth, but... freaks me out at the same time. Oh, here we go. Is that a fragment of something? Sea truck. Here we go. I think we just unlocked the sea truck. Oh my god, it's a cute little, like, thing, like the sea glide. Not the sea glide. I forget what it's called. The sea something. We just unlocked an advanced wiring kit as well. Sea truck, we don't want to scan that. We'll just get loads of titanium.
New technology acquired. Warning. 30
oh my.
Seconds of oxygen remaining.
It goes so deep. Jesus. Give me the mobile vehicle bay fragment that I want and I'm out. I am never coming back.
Altera beacon signature detected. Unique identifier.
Oh, here
Delta
we go.
Delta Station dock.
Delta Station. This is the place Lil mentioned in her message.
Oh yeah, that's the, yeah. Oh my god! That's a sea truck fragment. We've already got that. Okay, those things are a lot bigger when they get close to you.
Warning. Passing 100 meters. Oxygen efficiency decreased.
Please don't get attacked. Please don't get attacked. Please don't get attacked. Right. There we go. We're out. That's it. We got what we came for.
Warning. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
With 500 meters. Oh my god, that thing. I haven't even seen it properly yet. I've only seen it at a distance. All I've seen is it's quick and they sound scary as hell. Oh my Jesus. Okay, right. Advanced material, synthetic fibers, ruby, spiral plant clipping. Dude. All right, we've unlocked a lot. Oh, power cell, advanced wiring kit. Right, so we need... titanium ingot, we can do that already. Upgrades, sea truck upgrade. So we'll pin that. So we need lubricant as well. We can actually, we've already got some stuff here to make that. And we need a computer chip. I can't remember what the computer chip needs. We need gold? Where the hell do you get gold from? Oh, this place in the dark. It looks so cool, but it's so scary at the same time. We'll have to go back up to the surface, come back down, and we'll use our little mineral scanner thing, see if we can find what we're looking for. What should we name her as well? What should we name our robot AI that's supporting us here? We need to name her. We need to humanize her a bit. Coral, there we go. Okay. He's just going for that stuff. It's fine. Right.
Warning.
Right, let's use our... Can we get these types? Oh, there's one right there. It's one of those things. Oh my god, there's a few...
Warning. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Oh my god, it's so dark. Oh my god, those things look awful.
Oxygen.
This is where the gold is, though. The noise that thing makes is striking fear into my heart. It's so dark in this area, I cannot see anything. Aha! Okay, this mineral thing is coming in handy. Oh, this is eerie. It's gone quiet. There hasn't been a silent moment once yet.
Warning. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
There's another one over there. We need to just take our chances and see if we can get an extra titanium. Oh, crap! Giant lobster thing. Okay.
Oxygen.
Take the silver, go. Oh no, oxygen. Ooh. I wasn't paying attention at all. I was so scared and so focused on getting out. I didn't even think about my oxygen. Okay. Right. Now that my heart has officially exploded out of my chest, let's go back and make some things. So now I feel like this area here is not so bad. It's that area with the big tubes, the steam, like, you know, the volcanic tube type things. Those things are terrifying. That area is awful. It's dark. It's got really nasty looking creatures. Not my cup of tea. Oh, that was so stressful all the way then. Every bit of that was so stressful. Oh, it's good to see these things again, honestly, to like have a repeat of everything. We'll make that at the beginning of the next part. So, I am so... Okay, right, this game is loud. One second. So, guys, this has been an amazing introduction to the game. It just feels so good to be back in new areas, new creatures, and just have all of that and unlocking all these new things and seeing what the game has in store for us. We have an objective for the next part, which will be Delta Station. We'll head that direction. We'll make the sea truck, and we'll see what that's all about and like kind of have some fun with that. And then we'll head to Delta Station and see what's going on over there. And I can't wait to see what other creatures they have in store on us. I still haven't seen those ones, the ones in the volcanic like tube area. I haven't had a good look at them yet. I've only seen them from a distance. But they look awful. They look absolutely terrifying. They're quick. They make nasty noises. Checking off every list on the fear scale for me. So, anyway, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed that. I said guys a lot there. It's okay. This happens sometimes. I hope you all enjoyed this first part introduction to the series. I'm sure it's going to be a long, joyous, terrifying journey from beginning to end. And I'll see you all in the next one. Goodbye, guys.